गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स एज वी नो दैट इन द चैप्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री वी हैव डिस्कस्ड मोस्ट ऑफ द थ्योरेटिकल पार्ट विद यू वी हैव डिस्कस्ड विद यू द इलेक्ट्रोलिटिकल सेल एज वेल एज द गैल्वेनिक सेल नाउ टुडे वी विल बी डूइंग सर्टेन न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम्स व्हिच आर गिवन टू यू इन असाइनमेंट वर्क द न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम इन द असाइनमेंट वन व्हिच आर गिवन टू यू are these numerical which are solved for you on the board. I hope you will be able to understand this. In this, the question number one is the electrical resistance of a column of 0.05 molar sodium hydroxide. The electrical resistance of a column of 0.05 molar sodium hydroxide solution of a diameter 1 centimeter. And the length 50 centimeters is this. You may see over here. What is the electrical resistance given? 5.55 into 10 is 3. What is the length of the solution? 50 centimeters. Concentration 0.05 molar NuH. And diameter was 1 centimeter. You have to calculate resistivity. Rho we have to calculate. Conductivity and molar conductivity. Now, what formula we have done is right. Resistance will be equal to rho into L upon A. Rho is the resistivity of conductor. Here, we have a value of R given to us in the question. It is given as 5.55 into 10 is 3. Length of a conductor is also given to us. And this is 50. Regarding the area of cross section is not given. Now, area of cross section of a wire will be pi r square. What is the value of pi? 3.14 into 0.5 square. Radius is 0.5. So, on solving it out, it comes out to be equal to 0.785 centimeters square. Now, if you put up all these values over here, this is 5.55 into 10 is 3 will be equal to rho into 50 upon 0.785. On solving this up, the value of rho will be equal to 87.135 ohm centimeter. So what will be the value of rho coming over here? It will be 87.135 ohm centimeter. This is the resistivity value we will be obtaining. Now, second part we have to find out is a conductivity or a specific conductance. Conductivity is equal to the reciprocal of resistivity or specific resistance. What is the value of rho over here? It is 87.135. So kappa, which will be the specific conductance, will be equal to 1 upon 87.135, on solving it up, it will come out to be equal to 0.01148 sine centimeter per centimeter. Am I clear? So first of all, we find out the specific resistance or the resistivity. Then we find out the specific conductance or conductivity. The specific resistance was found by the formula R was equal to rho into L upon A. So rho was equal to R into A upon L. Putting up all the values, we find out the value of specific resistance, which comes out to be equal to 87.135 ohm centimeter. Now, kappa was equal to 1 upon rho. Or specific conductivity or specific conductance was equal to 1 upon rho, which was equal to this one. Now, third is, we have to find out the molar conductivity. We also have a formula for finding out the molar conductivity. It will be equal to kappa into 1000 upon molarity. Putting up all the values, kappa, which is conductivity, will be equal to 0.011 into 48 as obtained over here. Into 1000 upon what the molarity of a conductor, it is given over here as 0.05. The C over here, molarity of the solution is given as 0.05. Putting up all these values, so molar conductivity will come to be equal to 229.6 Simon centimeter square per. Is it clear?
So this is how you will find out the molar conductivity of the solution. Molar conductivity of the solution will be equal to 229.6 Simon centimeter square per. How do we find out the molar conductivity? It will be equal to kappa into 1000 upon molar. You must know all this problem. How do we find out kappa? It is 1 upon rho. And how do we find out rho? Rho was equal to R into A upon M. So these three formulas, so specific resistance, we know how to find out the specific resistance, we know how to find out the specific conductance, and we know how to find out the molar conductance. This is almost assured in the board examination. The question related to these three formulas will be asked in the board examination. I again repeat, R is equal to rho into L upon A. R was resistance of a conductor, rho is the specific conductance, specific resistance, L is the length of conductor, A is the area of conductor. Now, specific conductance will be equal to 1 upon rho. Fine. Then, molar conductance will be equal to kappa into 1000 upon molarity of the solution. Am I clear? Or molar conductivity will be equal to 229.6 Simon centimeter square per. This is how we will find out this. Can you do this three formulas? Since you will be entering into your examination in online form, that is your examination is to be taken in the online mode. Fine, it is to be taken in online mode. So, now after this question number 1, let us come to the question number 2. The question number 2 again is solved for you student. The question is, the molar conductivity of 1.5 molar solution of an electrolyte line is found to be 138.9 Siemens centimeter square per mole. So molarity is given and the molar conductivity is given. The question is, calculate the conductivity of the solution. Now here again we have a formula, molar conductivity will be equal to conductivity into 1000 upon molarity of the solution. We have to find out conductivity or specific conductance. So what will be the formula? 138.9 is the given value of the molar conductivity. This will be equal to kappa into 1000 upon 1.5. On solving it out, we obtained a specific conductance or the conductivity, which comes to be equal to 0.0208 per ohm per centimeter. So all the formulas are getting clear to you student. One formula was R was equal to rho into L upon A. R was resistance, rho was specific resistance, L is the length of a conductor and A is the area of cross section. Then second was the resistivity or specific conductance was equal to 1 upon rho. And third, the molar conductivity was equal to specific conductance into 1000 upon molarity of the solution. Molar conductivity will be equal to 2, substituting this value. The same was the numerical problem here. Here we have found out the value of kappa, which is the value of specific conductance, or we may call it as a conductivity of the solution. Now look at the question number 3. The equivalent conductance of NaCl, HCl and sodium acetate. This is a question on the Kohler's law. So with this type of a numerical problem, the first section of the it will be over. The equivalent conductance of NaCl, HCl and sodium acetate at infinite dilution R given is, the equivalent conductance of NaCl is 126.4, HCl is 425.9 and sodium acetate is 91 Simon centimeter square per mole, respectively at 25 degrees C. Question is, calculate the equivalent conductance of acetic acid at infinite dilution. Am I getting clear? What we have to find out? The equivalent conductance of acetic acid at infinite dilution. What is given to us? We are given with the conductivity of HCl is given as, or the equivalent conductivity of HCl, molar conductivity of HCl is given as 426. Then molar conductivity of sodium acetate is given as 91 Siemens centimeter square per mole.
And molar conductivity of NaCl is given as this value. So we are given with it the molar conductivity of HCl, molar conductivity of sodium acetate, and molar conductivity of sodium chloride. Now, what is to be done? We have to find out the molar equivalent conductivity of acetic acid. It is given at infinite dilution. Equivalent conductivity of acetic acid in terms of a molarity of acetic acid. It will be the equivalent conductivity of acetate ion or ionic conductance of acetate ion plus ionic conductance of hydrogen ion. We will be using these three information of conductivity of HCl, sodium acetate and NaCl to find out the equivalent conductivity of acetic acid at the infinite dilution. How we will be doing this? Now just see over here, the molar conductivity of sodium acetate is given as this. If you apply the Kolar's law, molar conductivity of sodium acetate will be equal to the ionic conductance of the acetate ion plus ionic conductance of sodium ion. We know that conductivity for the weak electrolyte will be equal to the summation of a conductance of the ions as per the Kolar's law. So this molar conductivity of sodium acetate will be equal to this value of acetate ion and sodium ion, and the numerical value of this is given as 91 sieving centimeters square per mole. Am I clear, student? So after finding out the applying the Kolar's law in case of sodium acetate, which was equal to the ionic conductance of acetate ion and the sodium ion. Similarly, if I say the molar conductivity to HCl will be equal to the ionic conductance of hydrogen ion and chloride ion, and what is the numerical value of this is given in the question? 425.9 siemens centimeter square per. Am I clear? Similarly, in the question, molar conductance of NaCl is given, and is given as sodium ion and the chloride ion, and the value will come to be equal to 126.4 siemens centimeter square per mole. Is it clear? Now, what is our requirement, student? We have to find out the molar conductivity or equivalent conductivity of acetic acid at infinite dilution. This will be equal to the ionic conductance of acetate ion and the hydrogen ion. Now we have got three equations. This is equation number 2. This is equation number 3. Yes? And earlier was the equation number 1. We have to adjust these three equations in this manner. So we obtain this part. Now acetate ion will come from the sodium acetate. Hydrogen ion will come from HCl. So what we have done is first plus second minus third. We have taken the three equations. This was equation number 1. So first plus second minus third. Am I clear? So what do we get? Molar conductivity at infinite dilution for acetic acid will be equal to molar conductivity at infinite dilution or equivalent conductivity at infinite dilution for sodium acetate plus HCl minus sodium chloride. Am I getting clear? What is this value given as per the data of the question? 91. What is this value given? 425.9. And what is this value given? It is given as 126.4. On solving it up, it will come out to be equal to 390.5 centimeter square per mole. Am I clear? So if we want to find out the conductivity or the more equivalent conductivity at infinite dilution for weak electrolyte, how it is to be done? It is to be done by using of a Kolar's law. And as per the Kolar's law, it will be equal to the ionic conductance of a cations as well as the ionic conductance of an ion. Here in this question, we were given the equivalent conductivity at infinite dilution for sodium acetate, for HCl and NaCl. Desirement was, or requirement was, to find out the equivalent conductivity at infinite dilution for acetic acid. Am I clear? What we did? We added first and second equation and subtracted the third equation. By doing that, we obtained this value. How? First was 91, then 425.9 minus 126.4. On solving, we got the value which was 390.5 centimeter square per. This is how equivalent conductivity at infinite dilution for acetic acid is obtained. Am I clear, student? And this is how the
question related to the Kolar's law is to be solved. Now we have done the four concept numerical problem. R was equal to rho into L upon A. Kappa was equal to 1 upon rho. And molar conductivity was equal to kappa into 1000 upon molarity. If it would have been normality, then the formula will be kappa into 1000 upon normality of the solution. Am I clear? Also remember L upon A was called as what? It was called as a cell constant. Now look at another problem. The question is, the conductivity of 0.00128 molar acetic acid is 4.95 into 10 raised to the power minus 5. The conductivity of acetic acid solution of this concentration is given as this value. What is to be done? Calculate its dissociation constant. Degree of dissociation is to be find out. Dissociation constant is to be find out. If equivalent conductivity at infinite dilution or acetic acid is given as this. This is another type of problem which can be asked. Conductivity of acetic acid is this. Of this concentration is this. We have to find out the dissociation constant if equivalent conductivity of acetic acid is this. Now how do we find out? We have a formula, molar conductivity will be equal to kappa into 1000 upon molarity. Find molar conductivity value is given as molar conductivity will be equal to kappa into 1000 upon molarity of the solution. Now here, how do you find out the molar conductivity? This will be equal to specific conductance into 1000 upon molarity. What is the value of specific conductance? 4.95 into 10 raised to power minus 5 into 1000 upon 0.001028. On solving it out, we find out the molar conductivity at this value. Now, molar conductivity at infinite dilution in the question is given as 390.55. So, we may from here find out the degree of dissociation. You must remember this formula, student. Very, very important formula. It can directly be asked as the 1 mark question in the board examination. Degree of dissociation will be equal to cap n upon cap m infinite. What is the cap n? At any concentration, will be equal to 48.15 to the cap n at infinite value will be equal to 390.5. So this value will come to equal to 0.1233. Am I clear? 0.1233. So degree of dissociation over here has been obtained. Now what is to be done? We have to find out the dissociation constant for acetic acid. Here comes the relationship between the law of equilibrium and the electrochemistry. Now acetic acid, when dissociate, it will form acetate ion and a hydrogen ion. What is the initial concentration of this? Suppose C, when the dissociation has not taken place, suppose this is 0 and this is 0. At the time of equilibrium, this will be C minus C alpha. This will be C alpha and C alpha. Try to recollect the 11th class one. How much it has dissociated? C alpha. This again is C alpha. So at the stage of equilibrium, this will be C minus C alpha, this is C alpha, this is C alpha. From here, we find out the dissociation constant, applying the law of cross section. So K will be equal to the concentration of acetate ion into hydrogen ion, into upon acetic acid. What is the concentration of this given? C alpha, this C alpha, and this is C minus C alpha. So this will become C square, so this was C alpha, into C alpha upon C minus C alpha. Solving it up, it comes to be equal to C square into alpha square upon C minus C alpha. Taking the C common from here, if you solve it up, student, so it will be equal to C square into alpha square upon C into 1 minus alpha. This will cancel out. So it will come out to be equal to C alpha square upon 1 minus alpha. Am I clear? Now putting up the value, what is the concentration given? It is coming to be 0.001028. 0.001028. This value. What is a degree of dissociation? 0.1233. This will be 1 minus 0.1233. So over here, the dissociation constant K will come to be equal to, or Ka you may write it up, dissociation constant. This will come to be equal to 1.78 into 10 raised to power minus 15. 1.78 into 10 raised to power minus 15. Am I clear, student?
So this is how it is to be done. So these are the certain types of problems which are to be done on the basis of the first part of our electrochemistry. Remember, some of the problems were also based on the Faraday's law, which will be discussed with you. I hope you must have understood these questions. We will meet again with the next lecture. Till then, thank you.